It was a chilly morning, but clear skies for the Pacific Grove Triathlon today. Hundreds gathered at Lover's Point to compete for a chance to qualify for the 2010 Escape from Alcatraz Triathlon. Here's Action News reporter Stephanie Truong.
The first obstacle between San Jose's Kelly Harris and the finish line, a 1.5 kilometer kelp crawl through the chilly waters off Lover's Point in Pacific Grove.
I've swam in the Pacific Grove in this area before, and I know about the kelp, but I'm not expecting that to be a problem.
Even less of a problem with family and friends steadfast on the sidelines.
2 days this weekend, she'll be at Scott.
Cheering on their determined loved ones.
I could never do it. It just scares me to have to be swimming in open water, but they're amazing. It's insane.
You could call it insane. Once on land, swimmers had to dry themselves off on the 40-kilometer bike ride.
You got it. Good job.
Then take off on foot, finishing Saturday's Olympic distance course with a 10K run.
It's all mental. You just have to believe that you can do it and your body will carry you through it.
I think they're pretty tough. I mean, I think these guys really train hard for these races.
Races made possible by community members who volunteered their time to make it all happen.
Just being able to help out and support the runners here and all these athletes is just a great way to be involved and support this kind of thing.
An event that reminds folks.
All right, ladies in pink, absolutely fantastic job.
That with a little heart, anything is possible.
For anybody who has never stepped outside their comfort zone, today is a good day to start. Every day is a good day to be alive. Just get out there and try something.
In Pacific Grove, Stephanie Truong, KSBW, Action News 8.
And the sprint distance triathlon for amateurs starts tomorrow morning at 7:15. It includes a quarter-mile swim, 12.5-mile bike course, and a 2-mile run.